okay? Sir? Are you okay?
Tired.
You were tired. Fine. I'm just gonna go.
Wait.
What?
Be sober. For your adversary, the devil, like a roaring lion, walketh about, seeking whom he may devour.
Okay. Thanks for that.
Together then, please.
There you go.
You're new in town, aren't you?
Yeah.
Congrac is such a small place, it's hard not to notice new faces. You moving in or just visiting?
Moving in.
Oh, lovely.
I was wondering, when I was driving in, why is the sign of the village a witch?
Ah, well, Congrac translated into English is Valley of the Witch.
Ah, right. So why is it called that?
I don't know, to be honest. Don't think anyone around here really knows why.
Oh. Okay. Well, thanks for that.
That's all right. Pop in any time.
I'll see you soon.
Welcome to Congrac.
Must be hard for you, Mrs. Robson. But if there's anything you can tell me about your son's state of mind, it'd be most helpful towards our inquiries.
I don't know what to say.
I understand how difficult this must be for you, Mrs. Robson, but I have to ask. Did Sam show any signs of depression?
No. Not at all. And I mean, I know sons keep a lot from their mothers when they get to a certain age. But I knew him better than he knew himself. He wasn't depressed. That's for sure.
You don't know where he could have got the gun from, Miss Robson. If there's anything you can think of that can give us an answer, some insight, just give me a call, yeah? See myself out, all right?
Sorry to bother you. I'm Barbara Christie. I live next door. I noticed you moving some of your luggage in, so I thought I'd bring you over a little welcoming gift.
Oh, thanks. That's really nice of you. I'm Kristen Matthews.
Welcome to the village, Kristen.
Oh, sorry. I'll be doing some painting. Do you want to come in for a cup of tea?
Oh, I don't want to impose. It looks like you're really busy.
No, you're not. Come on in.
Look, I hope you don't think I'm just some curtain twitcher who's come over to get all the gossip about you.
No, not at all. It's really nice to have someone welcome me here. I wouldn't have got that in London.
So you're from the Big Smoke?
Mm. Yeah.
How come you've moved all the way down here?
My auntie died recently and I inherited the house. You know, they advised me to rent it or sell it, but it came at the right time, so I thought, move here myself.
Looking to escape the rat race?
I divorced a couple of months ago and I thought, you know, I need some fresh surroundings, fresh start.
Look, feel free to say no to this if you want. I'm having a couple of friends over at my house tomorrow night. They're from the village too. Oh, you're more than welcome to join us.
Yeah. Okay. Why not?
Great.
Thank you.
generally. Wife says he was happy. No signs of depression and not a single reason in the world to do it.
Yeah, but who knows what goes through people's minds, though, right?
Two suicides so close together. We haven't had a suicide in this town for years, man.
Wow, it's like buses, isn't it? You wait forever for one, then two come along together.
Some respect, will you? It's just people's lives we're dealing with here.
Hi.
You made it. It's great to see you. Come on in. Guys, this is Kristen.
Hi.
Kristen, hey. This is Richard and Shannon Griffiths.
Hi.
Take a seat. Now, do you want a cup of tea or coffee?
Tea, please.
Milk, sugar?
Milk, one sugar.
Coming out.
So Barbara tells us you've moved in next door.
Yeah, a couple of days ago.
How are you finding it so far?
Yeah, it's lovely. Such a difference from London. Everyone up there is, you know, rushing from place to place, but here it's a lot more chilled, a lot slower pace of life. Definitely what I need right now.
Yeah, I know what you mean. I used to live in London myself, moved here about 15 years ago, would never go back. Are you married?
No.
Lucky you.
Hey!
See, sometimes marriage is war.
There we go.
Great. All right.
Yeah, thanks. That's a nice piece on the wall, Bob. What is it?
It's a pentacle.
A pentacle? What's that?
Well, in most Wiccan traditions, it's seen as representing the element of earth.
Wicca? Isn't that like witchcraft or something?
I suppose some people call us white witches.
You're a white witch?
Yes.
Oh.
We're white witches too.
Look. You guys aren't trying to recruit me or anything, are you?
Oh, not at all. If you hadn't asked about the pentacle, I wouldn't have mentioned it.
Thank you.
Sister tried to get him on the phone all day. When her husband came round, when they couldn't get an answer, they broke in. Found him.
What'd you think?
It looks like another...
Jesus Christ. That's the third one this week. What the hell is going on here, huh?
Maybe it's just a coincidence.
Too.
I was surprised you rang. I haven't heard from you for a while.
Yeah, look, sorry, but I've been really, really busy.
Yeah, your father always said you'd be a hard-working man.
Shame he wasn't around to see it, don't I?
Tried his best, Jim. You know, I promised him I'd be here for you to talk, provide advice if you needed it. I'm guessing that's why you called.
Well, no. Well, I don't need advice. I just wanted to chat, but...
It's a stretch, isn't it?
Yeah. It's... Do you know... People are saying it's just an unusual coincidence. Fancy that, huh?
But you don't think so?
Mm-mm. No, I don't.
What's on your mind, Jim?
Faith. Let me ask you something. What really makes you believe in the things you do?
It's a question I've asked myself many times. Some people look at science and it shows you certain facts, how the world and mankind evolved. And all their questions are answered. These people tend to lead with their heads. But I lead with my heart. When I see science and evolution and all that stuff, I am left with a question. How can a world that is so beautiful not have some unexplained divine touch? Faith is not something I think, Jim. It's something I feel. Well, there's one thing I can tell you. People keep most things to themselves. No one knows what a person's really feeling deep down. We show one face to the world and keep another to ourselves.
Do you do that?
Sometimes. But I have people coming to me for help. I need to be strong for them. Maybe deep down, though, I'm not so strong. Maybe sometimes I'm scared.
What is it?
This is going to sound really strange. You were in my dream.
I know.
Are you saying we shared the exact same dream? I've got to go.
No, please, don't go. We've got to talk about this.
What's there to talk about?
What we saw.
It was just a dream.
If it was just a dream, then why did you come here? You know it's not just a dream. It's a vision that means something, and it's something important.
What do you think it means?
I don't know. But don't you want to find out?
In 1614, Cumgrach was a place where white witches settled after leaving Pendle Hill due to Christian persecution. Despite the peace-loving practices of the white witches, three of their number, led by the infamous Agatha Blackwood, staged a mutiny and eventually broke away to form their own witchcraft coven. Agatha Blackwood, Agnes Morehouse, and Esmeralda Cromwell were charged with blasphemy and burnt alive in a public ceremony on Cumgrach Beach.
That's what I saw.
But it doesn't mention everything that we saw here.
What do you mean?
It doesn't mention the curse one of the witches put on the village.
Yeah. buried on the living room floor of my house.
All right. You two stay here. Don't answer the door until I get back. And then have a look. Nothing there. No sign of a disturbance, no blood, and no body.
Then he must have gotten away.
The house is undisturbed. There's no signs of forced entry, Miss Matthews.
So what are you saying? I'm lying.
I didn't say that, did I?
He had a pentagram carved onto his wrist.
A pentagram?
Yeah.
And what exactly would you like me to do about that, Miss Matthews?
Huh? What about these red marks? And this blood?
You could have done that to yourself for all I know, all right?
You!
Hey, what's your language?
You're making me out to be a fantasist.
I'm not making you out to be anything. I'm a policeman working on the premise of facts. So far, there's none of them here, there, or anywhere, Miss Matthews. Now, I checked the whole house. It's fine.
Then he must have cleaned up before he fled.
Miss Matthews, come on, ya. Do you really believe that if a man's been stabbed in the neck, he's gonna clean up after himself?
You believe whatever you want. I know what happened.
Look, I'm just trying to do my job, all right? If you show me some facts and evidence, I'll gladly look at them, Miss Matthews, all right? But until then, I'll bid you good night, ladies.
Probably be a good idea to get a bit of rest, yeah?
This house?
No, I need to leave this place, this village. I need to go back to London. Something or someone doesn't want me here.
Well, you know, I'd be sad to see you go. But I understand if you want to leave.
Look, why don't you come with me?
That's really nice of you to offer. But I don't think so. This is my home.
Look, Barb. don't want to leave you. I just feel it's not safe around here right now.
It's fine. I totally understand.
So what have we got here then?
Some old guy. I've never seen him in the village before. Puncture wound to the neck. Dog walker found him this morning. Coroner's on his way.
Small and circular. It doesn't look like it.
What is it?
Moved in, yeah?
Yeah, but I'm packing everything up again.
You're leaving?
Yeah.
Well, it looks like I just came at the right time then, didn't I?
Look, if you came to patronise me again, you can save it. I can redo without it right now, okay?
Actually, I come to tell you we found a body.
What?
Yeah. It's got a wound and a distinctive symbol like the one you told me about last night.
You mean he's dead?
Yeah.
For that. I'm sorry, I don't want to wish anyone dead or anything, but I just feel safer knowing he's not going to come back.
Well, he's not coming back, that's for sure. Look, I'm going to need you to come down to the station with me to identify the body, if that's all right.
Yeah. That's him.
100%.
Yeah. I'll never forget his face.
Listen. I got my attitude when you first reported this. You understand my position.
Yeah. Don't worry about it. Just please, he's not going to come after me again.
I need to take a statement off you before you go, is that right?
Yeah. Of course.
You wish to add, yeah?
No. It's all there.
All right, then. If you just want to sign at the bottom of the sheet, Dad.
Okay. There you go.
Great. Well, that's you for now. You're free to go, yeah?
There is something else I want to talk about.
What?
I know this is going to sound really weird.
No, go on.
Do you know that pentagram on the man's wrist?
Yeah.
I had a dream about that symbol. Look, I know this sounds strange, but in my dream, there were witches being executed centuries ago here on the beaches in Cymraeg. They all had these pentagrams carved into their foreheads.
So what are you trying to say, Miss Mathesa?
That maybe there's some kind of connection here. That maybe the same kind of witchcraft is going on today. That maybe that man was a Satan worshipper or something, I don't know. I do sound crazy, don't I?
No, look. You don't sound crazy, all right? Maybe he was just a loner into some strange beliefs, no?
Then why would he come after me?
Well, let's look at it, right? You live in your home, yeah?
Yeah.
Well, maybe it's just that. You live near home, new to the village. Pretty. I'd say that makes you a target for unwanted attention, Miss Matthews. Thankfully, I really do think this is it's an isolated case here. You really don't have anything to worry about. When exactly are you leaving the village?
Tomorrow.
All right, yeah, tomorrow. Well, I got your details, just in case we need to call you for the case or something, yeah?
Thank you.
Yes, it is.
Hi, Barb. I'm just at the shop. Can I pop over in a bit?
You've got to come over now. It's important.
What is it? What's wrong?
Just come over. We'll talk about it then.
Okay. I'll come over as soon as I get back.
Cheers. Thanks.
Cheers. Hi. Have you got any spare boxes?
Yeah, sure. I'll just pop out back.
Is there anything you want to talk about? Well, please.
Do you believe in evil as an entity? A dark force that can influence and affect people.
Do you know, I'm a very rational man. I tend to find a rational explanation for most things.
So you don't believe that a dark force from the past can influence people in the present?
What are you getting at?
Something going on in this village, Father. Something evil.
A couple of weeks ago, I would have implored you to look at things in a more rational way. But some of what I've seen lately, well, what I've felt, there just is no rational explanation for any of it.
What have you seen?
The presence of evil. It's taken on different forms, but I've seen some strange things lately. Nightmarish things. I kept it to myself, too fearful to tell anyone, lest they question my sanity.
You're not crazy, Father. My friend, Barbara, and I, we've also seen things.
Don't worry. I won't scoff. My mind is open to whatever you have to say. Not so long ago, I wouldn't have even considered the matter, but I know what I've seen. Death has come to our little village, Kristen. And if you have any theory that may be able to explain why, then I would like to hear it.
Agatha Blackwood, Agnes Morehouse and Esmeralda Cromwell were put to death on the beach at Cumgrach in 1614. At their death, they put a curse on the descendants of Cumgrach. Look at this, Father. This confirms that every person involved in this spate of suicides had a bloodline connected to the villagers from the 1600s.
Jim Urquhart. He's a descendant too. I knew him very well. After his father died, I tried to watch over him. Evidently, I didn't do a very good job of that.
It's not your fault, Father.
Spiritual matters are supposed to be my forte. Jim spoke to me about the suicides. If only I had told him what I had seen.
What do you think we can do?
I think we should go over to Richard and Shannon's house. I'm sure Richard would know a spell or a prayer that can help us.
Yes. I've noticed some of the things you have on display here. I live my life by the Bible, and the Bible categorically denounces any and all occult practices. In Deuteronomy it says, follow no one who practices divination or sorcery, who interprets omens, engages in witchcraft, casts spells, or who is a medium or spiritist, or consults the dead. Anyone who does these things is detestable to the Lord.
Even if that sorcery is the purpose of good and not evil.
The church makes no distinction.
Will you come with us, Father?
I'm afraid I can be of no further use to you here.
All the best then, Father.
Father! I fear you may be in danger.
Very possibly. But I'll seek counsel with the God I know. If either of you wishes to embrace that, you know where to find me.
Thank you.
You can type my details on first if you like.
No, it's okay. I'll put mine in first.
My auntie, isn't it? She's a direct descendant.
It's not that.
What is it?
Barbara, hi. How's it going?
Not so good, Richard. Can we come in?
Yeah, sure. Okay. Come in. Wow, that's quite a story.
It's not just a story, though, Richard. It's true.
Okay. I believe you, but why are you telling me this?
Is there something we can do?
Well, this isn't something I've ever done before, but, yeah, I can think of something to try.
Great. Can I use the bathroom before we start?
Of course. You know where it is.
The ritual.
You could say that. I'm glad you find it funny. Humor takes the sting out of this.
What the hell do you think you're doing?
Thank you.
welcome back our slain sisters. They will bathe in the blood of those who betrayed them and usher in a new dawn for the Valley of the Witch. Combining the last of the Blackwood bloodline with those who betrayed our sisters will herald new life.
Bastard! You betrayed your own wife! You betrayed us all!
Blame your aunt. If she hadn't been so inconsiderate as to die, maybe you wouldn't even be here right now.
Scumbag! You'll pay for this. One day. You'll get what you deserve.
Start the fires.
No!